All you've got to do for any of your listeners out there is come up with an idea of what you want to do, and it's pretty much you can do anything you want.
This podcast encourages and empowers you to create your own unique real story, develop your own unique real statement, and discover your own unique real self. The power is yours. Good afternoon, David Ralph. Previously, episode 174 of the 12-Minute Convos podcast, 2 years, 8 months, 12 days, and 15 hours ago.
I would say to everyone that if you want to be a podcaster, do it, but do it in your own style because you will have so much fun.
David, it is a great pleasure to reconnect with you. What's going on? What's new in your world?
Oh, I don't know about new, but I'm slightly shocked that I suddenly realized there was 173 other people before me. I wasn't your first. I'm shocked by that. It didn't dawn on me at the time, but when I heard that, I thought 173 other people better than me. How's that possible, Engel?
Well, you know, you said it right there. And one of the things that happened at the beginning of the podcast were individuals would look at my name and say, Engel. And it's actually Angel. And I'm so glad that you are one of the 174 that did that.
Is it Angel? Angel like Angel?
It is Angel. Yeah.
You see, you've thrown me off now. I'm all over the shop. This is going to, this won't be a 12-minute conversation. This is going to be like a 12-hour conversation. But I've got it. Angel, like Angel. Angel.
There we go. Yeah, so I told you I would have done that just before we got started. Success. You told me it wasn't possible, though, to embarrass you on the podcast.
You can't possibly. I say so many stupid things myself that literally I have an indoor sort of a mechanism where my blush factor left ages ago. So whatever I say just goes out and it runs around the world and people think, what an idiot.
What a wonderful way of joining up the dots. Dig in here. Tell us about what's going on with the podcast, David. I had the opportunity to get on there and have a conversation with you, which was absolutely amazing. What's new?
This week, actually, we've started creating live support groups across the world, and it's starting to take a life of its own. Because you realize with a podcast that there comes a time that actually it's all one way, and to get the real power, you've got to invite listeners into your life somehow. And so what we're doing, we've got a group in New Zealand, Tasmania, Australia, a few in England, a few in America, and we build them out so that people will have a local community of people that don't just listen to me but can support each other. And the whole metric, Angel, is the fact that it has to be positive. There can't be any negativity, there can't be any sniping. And every day people come into the groups and they post what they're grateful about. And the idea is that we're going to get all these groups across the world, then we will connect them by broadcasting in on bulk, and then start having experts meeting with these guys, actually mentoring them live in their towns. So we're kind of joining up the dots live, but it takes a bit of a time to get going.
That's amazing. So what platform are you using for this?
Oh, I go easy. I do. It's a platform called Facebook. And I don't do anything clever. And I think if there's something that easily connects the world, then just use that. You know, I see people going, oh, I've got to design this, I've got to design that. I just think if it's there and it's really easy and people know how to use it, then get it to work. The problem I had was actually being able to do Facebook Live into 150 Facebook groups at the same time. That was a bit of a sort of practical mission to sort out. But I've resolved that now. And so not only am I a podcaster, Angel, I'm a TV host.
That's amazing.
A TV host blasting through the world into Facebook. And technology can really, all you've got to do for any of your listeners out there is come up with an idea of what you want to do. And it's pretty much, you can do it. You can do anything you want.
So what's the best way for an individual that, I mean, their ears just perked up, right? How can they join one of these groups?
Well, first of all, they've got to tell me to create one because we're building them all the time. So if they're in their local community, and what we're trying to do is make it as dot-based as possible. So it's not that they've got to travel hundreds of miles. It will just be in their town, whatever. Tell us, we'll create it, and then we will start linking it up. And it's all very small at the beginning because people sort of not really sure what they're doing. But you start to get movement and people start to sort of understand it, and then it gets legs. And so all they've got to do is drop us a line, come over to the website, we will create a group, and then we'll start connecting and supporting and encouraging. And it doesn't take a lot, Angel, does it, before you change lives?
Definitely, which brings us to the conversation of you and your values. Over the last 3 years, you've definitely stuck to the goal that you've set in terms of joining up. How does it make you feel looking back over that timeline?
Well, I'm just reflecting on your sexy voice, Ben. As you were saying that, I realised that you could turn me. You could turn me away from my wife, Angel, with a voice like that. Now, looking back on it, it's amazing, really, because so much of it is a mess. And you probably feel like that because you're involved in it all the time and you're aware of what you haven't done and what you need to do. A lot of it just seems like you're making it up as you go along. And then you look at it from outsiders' points of view and you think, wow, actually, it looks quite sexy. You know, the whole thing looks quite professional. And the fact, little things like I've got a book out, which I never dreamt I'd have a book out.
What's the name of the book?
It's called Podcaster's Mastery, How to Define Your Celebrity with the Power of Your Voice. I think that's what it's called. It's up on my shelf and I can't quite see it because Tim Ferriss is in the way, but that's the book. And a guy came along and said, you know, would you like to do it? And the fact now that I've got a book in the British Library, because in Britain every single book that's published has to have a copy in a library.
Wow.
And I think, oh, that's a little legacy. When I've come and gone, somebody might go along that shelf and see my face.
Let's dig into the legacy side. 5 children, 1 grandchild when we last spoke. Has that bunch grown?
Yeah, I've got another grandchild now. I've got a daughter now. I've got a grandson called Jamie and a daughter called Evie. And they're very miserable. They're very miserable, Angel. You know, you see these films and these TVs when the grandkids are like delightful and the grandparents love having them around. I shouldn't really say this on a podcast, but they're not the kind of kids that you want to spend a lot of time with. They're really, really grumpy.
Your comedy is A+. One of your desires, as expressed on the conversation we had, was a desire to continuously have fun. Have you been able to pull that off?
Yeah, I have actually, and I think what's the beautiful thing about doing anything online is you practice when no one's listening. And when you start something, you think, oh, you know, the world's going to listen, and they don't. So you kind of get better at it. And then I found that I was trying to bring comedy and entertainment into my business podcast, but the guests weren't ready for it. But now I've been going for 5 years, most of them know what they're going to get, and when somebody knows what they're going to get, they meet you halfway, and so it's so much easier to have, you know, much better conversation. And I try to blend it. It's quite difficult, really, to do business advice while having motivation, while having comedy, and sort of blend it into a smorgasbord. Don't always get there, but that's the idea. Because I think, you know, if you can't have fun, you might as well go back to work where it wasn't fun. And you just sort of sat there all the time waiting for 5 o'clock so that you could get out. So everything I do, I think it's got to have that element of smile behind it.
Even in the corporate world, you were flicking the ears of individuals while being there. And that intrigued me so much because it seems as though you've been adamant about being the individual that's true to who they are. And I really appreciate that because so many times individuals get on the mic and they attempt to be like someone else. And you said that on the podcast as well, way back then, right? That it's so important to do something that's unique to who you are. So, I mean, I salute you, David, in terms of how you've set out to accomplish your goals and how you've kept the family model going right beside you, parallel to everything you're doing.
Yeah, can I flick your ears? When we meet,
please,
can I flick your please. Ears? Because you have got remarkable ears.
Please flick my ears. Now, do you still do not have a cell phone?
I have actually gone even further. I don't have a landline now. I've got this big thing about not being able to be contacted. And I'm very professional and prompt. And so, like, this interview, you tell me I'm going to be there, I will be there. And so if I've arranged it, it happens. But if it doesn't, I can't bear the thought of somebody just buzzing and notifying me. And I was looking at my landline the other day and I thought, I'm going to unplug it out of the wall. And so I unplugged it and smashed it up. So I've now got no phone at all.
Oh my. And you're living still.
It's brilliant having no phone. It's a bit of a pain sometimes when there's a circular route that has to go through my kids so that I can go and pick them up. But it's a lot better. People always say, oh, what are you going to do if there's an emergency? There's not an emergency, is there?
One of the themes of our conversations, as comical as you can deliver, has been integrity. How's that been going as well?
I think, once again, if you play to your strengths and you're consistent, it just naturally occurs. Yeah, I've got a big bugbear at the moment, Angel, and it's those YouTube videos where the people are by the infinity pool or they're at that private jet and they're saying, you know, oh, just buy my course and you can have X. I hate all that. I hate all that. Mm. I want people to know that in many regards, I've made it up as I go along. You know, every day I'm trying something new and sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. I think that's the only way that you can really get true integrity is by being consistent and sharing your screw ups. And that's what I try all the time. I don't try to make everything look polished, and I don't certainly walk on a plane and then think, oh, there's a private jet. Take a video of me so it looks like it's mine. I don't do any of that. I just think it's all fake.
Success is built on the foundation of failures is one of the things I love to say. Failures being in air quotes, because I think even that word needs to be just looked over, because is it really a failure if it's the thing that got me to the thing I was hoping to reach?
I think it is sometimes, definitely. Isn't it? And I know what you say, you know, oh, there's no failures, it's only learning. But I think sometimes you've got to go, yeah, actually, that was a failure. That was just a, you know, I didn't gain anything from it other than knowing not to do it again. Because yes. I have screwed up massively on some stuff where now 5 years down the line, I think, ah, I've got that. I could do that. And it's almost like it was a brilliant idea at the wrong time, that kind of thing. And so there's so much work that I've got that I've built up over the last 5 years that I'm just sort of like reaching in and bringing it out and people going, ah, you're amazing. You're doing so much work. And I think, well, actually, I'm not doing that much work. I did this 4 years ago, but I'm not going to tell you. I just sort of bring it to the fore. So I do think sometimes there are failures.
Well, David, again, my friend, this conversation, I would like to take this little second here to say thank you, my friend. Thank you for showing up as who you are. Thank you for being true to your own unique real self. And thank you for now being what the podcast considers, what I consider you being the foundation of the 12 Minute Convos podcast. I appreciate you from the bottom of my heart, my friend. In closing, is there anything else you'd like to share with our amazing audience?
Yeah, would you mind getting off my lap now? You're getting a bit warm, and it's that wiggling thing that you're doing. It's really uncomfortable.
David Ralph, thank you for being on What is Inspired by 12 Minute Convos with Angel Jones. This podcast is produced by Pod Edits. Visit podedits.com for professional podcast publishing.